Hello everyone, I am Dr. Atmanand Hegde. I am working as a consultant orthopedic surgeon in KMC Hospitals, Mangalore. I'll be briefly giving information about hip fractures in elderly population. These hip fractures are some of the most common problems that we see in our orthopedic clinical practice. Hip per se refers to a joint in the groin region between thigh bone and the pelvic bone, and it is shaped in the form of a ball and socket. These hip fractures are particularly common in elderly population because of underlying problem of senile osteoporosis. Senile osteoporosis basically means age-related weakening of bone density and structure. Other risk factors for these hip fractures in elderly populations are neurological problems which affect the balance and stability and gait, and also visual acuity problems which predispose them for frequent falls. And comorbid conditions like diabetes, hypothyroidism, chronic kidney disease, and long-term usage of drugs which adversely affect the bone density. These hip fractures adversely affect the independence of patients and makes it impossible for them to take care of themselves and to do activities of daily living. And it increases the burden on the family and society. Hip fractures are usually sustained following trivial trauma or low energy injuries like stumbling or slipping and falling in washrooms. The symptoms of hip fractures are acute severe pain in the groin region and inability to bear weight on the injured limb. So treatment part of these hip fractures can be grouped under four phases, namely the prevention phase, optimization phase, treatment proper, and rehabilitation phase. In prevention phase, we sensitize the elderly patients who come to our outpatient department about the need to take care of their bones and muscles. The measures we recommend are the following, like fall prevention at home, like using walking aids, like walking stick and walker stand, decluttering the living areas, using grab bars and anti-slip mats in washrooms. Regular checkup of neurological conditions and visual acuity to prevent frequent falls. And regular physical activity to maintain bone and muscle strength. Diet improvements so that they consume appropriate amount of calcium and vitamin D in their diet. Second phase is optimization phase. Invariably, these patients will be having multiple comorbidities like diabetes, hypertension, and heart problems. So it is a multidisciplinary approach in the hospital which involves orthopedic surgeon, physician, cardiologist, and physical therapist. Third phase is treatment proper. Generally, fractures can be treated in two ways, namely conservative treatment, which involves splinting, casting, and medications, and the other option is surgical treatment. Conservative treatment in these hip fractures can produce undesired outcome with increased rates of complications like bed sores, pneumonia, urinary tract infection, and deep vein thrombosis. So as far as treatment of hip fractures in elderly, surgical treatment is a must. The ultimate goal of surgical treatment in these patients is to restore them to pre-injury status as early as possible so that they can take care of themselves. Lastly, the rehabilitation phase involves various physical therapy modalities with the help of physiotherapists and family members so that patients can get back to their pre-injury status. And also before discharge, we put these patients on long-term osteoporosis treatment to prevent a future fracture risk. That is in brief about hip fractures in elderly patients. In the end, I would like to say that in our hospital, we have an excellent group of experienced surgeons and support staff to take care of these hip fractures in elderly populations.